Hey everyone, today I'm gonna take you on a quick tour of an mRNA biochemistry lab, specifically the one that I work in. So, safety first. Since I'm the only one here, I'm gonna take the mask off. And this is where the magic happens. So this is where I do a bunch of my writing and data analysis, sitting on that computer. But the actual science happens right here on this bench. So most of my experiments are being taken place here, whether that's doing Western blots or preparing qPCR, or especially making mRNA through in vitro transcription. So I have my MVPs, my pipettes right here. Wouldn't have been able to get through the PhD without them, that's for sure. And I have a bunch of just common reagents that I use on a day-to-day basis. So I have like some buffers here, a lot of things that can be used to run gels. I have a bunch of different alcohols and things up here for when I'm making that mRNA. And let's go check out some cells. This is the tissue culture room, so where we take care of all of our cells. So cells are shown in here. I'm gonna show you some cells under the microscope. You'll be able to see. So we're treating these cells with different drugs, maybe we're giving them mRNA, maybe we're trying to knock out a certain protein or overexpress it, and then we see how they react. We don't want to keep them out too long because, just like us, they like to be warm and keep them safe. Let's go check out the radioactive room. So this is where we do some type of radioactive experiments. We also have some microscopy experiments that we do here. So if we're trying to label certain proteins, you can do something called S35 labeling, so we can see what proteins are being made inside the cell at real time. So that's a great experiment we like to do a lot. And if we're trying to image cells, so we stain them, give them different dyes, see where proteins are localizing, see different organelles, that's what we're gonna use over there. Let's go see where I like to make all those videos. So this is the whiteboard that I use for all those videos, like how does the mRNA vaccine work? You're standing right where that viral video took place. So I like to draw all my images here and then have it recorded by a friend before posting it online so everyone can be educated. Let's go check out some more stuff in the lab. So let's check out this room, which I'm a little OCD, so I want to have everything in order. This is our chemicals. They're in alphabetical order with little labels, so you can easily find them when you're trying to find a reagent. You're in a rush, you want to quickly be able to grab it. So we got shelf stable. Things are in alphabetical order in our minus 20, in our 4 degree, and in our minus 20 is actually where we keep all those lipids that we've either bought or that we've synthesized in order to make the lipid nanoparticles. Which is probably the coolest part of this room, the microfluidics device, which I helped put together with Precise Genome in order to build this, which is what mixes the lipid nanoparticles, or the LNPs, with the mRNA that we've made in order to make the final product. And then that final product is what we're gonna use to treat cells or to treat mice in order to see how is that mRNA reacting in a living system. Now, one of the really cool things about this is that I actually built not only the microfluidics device, but also this super cool container. I used power tools, a lot of glue, tape, and put this together all by myself as a protective plexiglass piece of equipment to protect that microfluidics device. So that's my legacy in the lab. Let's go check out some other stuff. So here is actually where we keep all cell lines. So that's because cells have to be kept super cold. So this is minus 80 degrees. And I'll give you an example, some cells that I have. So we freeze them in these little vials. We keep them at minus 80. and that actually protects them. So that way, when we want to thaw them, we can warm them to room temperature, throw on some media, and then hopefully they'll start growing just like what you saw earlier. So this is our storage conditions for them. All right, and the last piece of equipment that I'm gonna show you today is a machine called the Cryostat, which is something that I use often in order to look at the tissues of tumors after I've treated them with mRNA. And the way it works is that the tissues are frozen, so a lot of the proteins are all intact, and then here is we're actually sectioning them into really, really tiny pieces in order to put them on a microscope slide, and then use different stains in order to image them. Kind of like what we did before with the cells, but this time it's actually in tissue. So the way that it works is that actually you put your tissue here. This is all frozen, as you can see that there's ice chunks here. And then as this machine is gonna go up and down, it's going to slice the tissue and give us those sections that we can then take a microscope slide, place it on there, and save it for future use. Well, that about wraps it up for what my daily life is like in this mRNA biochemistry lab. Hopefully you were able to learn something today and you were able to get a glimpse at what happens in some of these research facilities. So leave a like, subscribe, and let me know in the comments what you want to see next. All right, hope everyone has a great day. See ya, bye.